Now, Ivan Pavlov was a researcher who was really studying saliva. He was what we would call a physiologist, and he was interested in saliva's role in the digestion process. For his experiments, he would collect saliva from dogs so he could study it under a microscope. But in order to get the saliva, he would give the dogs a special food powder, and this made the dog salivate, and he would collect the saliva. But pretty soon, Pavlov started to notice that the dogs would salivate just to seeing the assistants in their white lab coats. And Pavlov wanted to know if he could make that happen on purpose. And so what he did was he would ring a bell. And whenever he rang the bell, he would feed the dogs right after that. And pretty soon, the dogs learned to associate the bell with the food powder. And so the dogs would start to salivate even before they got the food powder. This is a classical conditioned response, and it's the first one that was really studied. Let me go over that just a little bit so that you can picture it a little better. Again, a stimulus is always something you see, hear, smell, touch, or taste. And in the case of Pavlov, he needs two stimuli. There's always two stimuli. In this case, it is the bell, which the dogs can hear, and the food powder, which the dogs can taste. Now, one of these has to be the unconditioned stimulus, and the other one has to be the conditioned stimulus, but we are going to call that the neutral stimulus at first. So, when you give a dog food powder, the dog will salivate naturally. You don't have to teach that. And so, therefore, that is our unconditioned stimulus and our unconditioned response. On the other hand, a dog is not going to salivate to the bell ringing. You can ring a bell in front of a dog essentially forever, and that dog is never going to think, that bell sounds yummy. That's not natural. And so, for this reason, we call the bell the neutral stimulus because it's neutral. It's not giving us the response that we're looking for. Of course, what Pavlov wanted to do was to make the dog salivate to the sound of the bell. And so you have to go through the process of classical conditioning. How does that work? Well, we put them together. So Pavlov rings the bell and then gives the dogs a food powder. And then, of course, the dogs salivate because of the food powder. And you can't do this just once. It won't work. You have to do it over and over and over again. So again, Pavlov rings the bell, he gives the dogs a food powder, and then the dogs salivate. And again, ring the bell, give the dogs food powder, and then the dogs salivate. And if you do that enough times, eventually that bell is going to take on new properties. And so the bell, all by itself, is going to give you the response. So now you ring the bell and the dogs salivate. And so now we call these the conditioned stimulus and the conditioned response. Why conditioned? Because conditions means that it was learned. So this is the learned stimulus and the learned response. It's a good way to think about it. Take a few moments to answer the next few questions.